He's solid.
In your opinion, can you give me some facts on that? Why is Islamic immigration a problem?
We've noticed a huge rise in numbers of rapes all over Europe, and that's due to Islamic immigration. That's coming from Afghanistan, the Middle East. That's Sweden, that's Germany, that's England, that's France. And the statistics are there, I'm talking facts, I'm not making this up.
So tell me something, why...
Have you not done the research?
I have, I'm listening to your research. And even if I agree with your research, can you tell me what's that got to do with the teaching of Islam? Are you saying to me that now because I've converted to Islam, I'm suddenly more likely to become a rapist? Because if I was to talk you through the teachings of Islam, it makes me far less likely.
As a woman, I don't want to feel unsafe in my country, and I now do. I don't want to be raped.
That's because you've been listening to the propaganda and the rubbish around. It's completely
it's facts.
So you're worried about walking up the road and getting raped by a Muslim?
Look, I thought
before you were saying there's grooming gangs on little girls.
I used to feel safe in my country, I don't anymore. I've heard that when you come to Hyde Park here, in the evening you can't come as a woman because you'll get touched and raped by the Muslim men. Okay. So why is that?
Well, you stay later and I promise you I'm not going to touch you.
I'm not talking about you.
I'm a Muslim. You're doing it as a general thing. So.
Why do you think we've got Muslim rape gangs all over the country?
Have you seen what's been happening in the papers lately? Have you seen what they've been doing?
Do you think that's made up?
No, grooming gangs is a particular term used to alienate sort of Asian sort of taxi drivers and on-street drivers.
So you don't believe it?
Well, how many white paedophiles do you think there are? How many white paedophiles men do you think there are? Do you think it's an Islamic problem, paedophilia?
No, we've got a problem in all cultures, but why do you think...
So then what are you talking about?
It's something like 74-84% of Pakistani Muslim men are raped. Where's that stat from?
Do you honestly believe that stat?
That's from Majid Nawaz.
Okay. There's no agenda there, is there?
Oh, so that's funny.
Do you know who Majid Nawaz is?
Yeah.
Of course he's going to say it.
He works for the Korean Foundation. So that's funny, is it? For you, that's just a go, oh well, it's not really a
problem. That's not reliable
as
facts.
A woman,
to me, that's not reliable source.
Why?
Because it's Majid Nawaz.
I think you need to do some more research.
I need to do more research.
Yeah, as a woman, it's worrying.
But you haven't given any kind of basis towards... I'm Muslim. Are you scared of me? Now you're saying a Pakistani problem. We're talking about Islam.
You gave me
a stat of Pakistanis. Are you saying it's a culture problem? Are you saying it's a religious problem?
I just don't think you want to listen to the fears that women have.
Okay, look, for the last bit.
How old was Aisha?
I touched her.
How old was Aisha? No, you can't. That's not me calling you a Shia. That's not me calling you a Shia.
But that's what you said. You said Islam.
So why do you always fight with each other? Because they believe in Ali and you don't believe in Ali. Mate, you agree with people here.
The Pope of Christianity, yes. I don't agree with the Pope because he doesn't represent the God of the Bible, because he's a devil worshipper, not a supporter. Even Putin said it. Do you agree with paedophilia?
Where's Ali Dawa anyway? Didn't he say he'd let his 9-year old daughter marry a man if she was physically, sexually, and mentally ready? This is disgusting. This is England.
This is England, the country of war.
The country of war. Yeah. So let's look at the caliphate. Let's look at the Ottoman Empire. I'll tell you what. This country's the greatest country in the world. That's why you're in it, bro.
It is.
Yeah. And you like Britain.
Religion of war. Same way. Like you generalise. We can generalise.
No, I don't edit anything. It's live, brother. I don't need to edit anything.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, it's brilliant. This is freedom of speech, isn't it, bro?
We're solid.
What I'm saying to you is, I look at what our government have done, corrupt element of our government, Tony Blair.
Sorry, are you Christian?
Yeah.
How old is Mary when she married Joseph?
Well, you
don't class that feeling,
yeah? I said I didn't.
So you agree?
But she's 12.
No. You answer the question, yes or no?
Did he have sex with her?
He grew
Did he have sex with her?
Did he not?
Huh? Like I said, I don't know.
How can you possibly know you weren't born then?
Did he know?
I asked him, he just asked me, she was just born.
No.
So now you don't know what we're talking about.
Either way, it's a sex
thing. Now you don't know what we're talking about, okay. As a woman,
James, what was your very first question to this man?
Repeat, exactly.
No, one we thought about for all time.
Oh, is Muhammad's example good for all the time? And you said, yeah. So if a 53-year-old man married a child in this country now, that would be paedophilia.
That was the first question, mate.
What I'm telling you is, you see, you are...
And where's the lady that said it's a Christian country?
This is my good friend.
Christian country.
What
does the Bible say about homosexuality? Does this country allow same-sex marriage?
Yes or no?
Why is the country not clamping down? My point is, why are they not clamping down on it? They're breaking the law of Christianity.
Yeah. Well, you let us deal with our problems.
England made this their problem when they decided to go and invade other countries.
That is not the people of Britain, that's the government.
Let's agree on one thing. Do you want your government to power? Jerusalem is the undivided capital of Israel, and it will always be the capital of Israel.
Inshallah.
He's not real. You don't even know if he's real.
Why are you all here, speakers?
Wait. One sec. Let me ask you a question. Are you praying to Mecca? Is the earth flat? Because I'm looking at Islam. You're praying on the floor, the earth is round, then you're not praying to Mecca,
you're praying into space.
I'm talking about it. Well, I'm just saying, I'm picking holes with your belief system. We're proving points.
You're here to learn knowledge. Is that why you're all here?
That's what I'm getting.
Then you need to use two ears and one mouth.
I am. I've got one mouth, 2 ears.
That means you talk less and you listen more.
No, but use my mouth. I have you talked.
If you want to learn.
I can't use my mouth and not talk.
If you want to learn, you use your ears more than your mouth.
I'm asking you on what you said. When you said about following the country's laws, earlier on you said it to me, you said follow the Christian law, but then you're like, the government don't follow the Christian law, but you're saying the government...
Every culture has their problems. Every country has their problems.
I understand that, but you
but
said...
But we, England, does not need Islam to bring their problems here.
Islam is not a culture.
That's what I have to say. Why are you all here?
Because you can't answer that question.
Because the government allows them.
Yes.
What can you do with the government?
No. What are you trying to do?
I'm not answerable to you.
What are you trying to do?
You want us to follow your government's laws, but you don't agree with your own government.
Who are you?
What are you trying to do here?
Are you following your government's
laws? Are you trying to convert everyone to Islam?
Do you know, if I was Prime Minister, you're never going to be Prime Minister. I've already done him, mate. Completely destroyed him. Absolutely destroyed him. Sadiq cunt. I destroyed him. I've taken the State of London to me. Trump's welcome, Khan's not. We love Trump.
Moment,
you destroyed him.
You destroyed him.
Are you trying to convert him?
The tide is changing.
Give me the name.
You ain't mayor, are you?
liar. Sadiq cunt. I did destroy him, mate. I'll check it on YouTube. Sadiq cunt. I'm down here, mate. I'm here challenging all you lot because I don't agree with your ideology, because this is Britain and we ain't bowing to no Islam, no Wahhabism, no Salafism, nothing. We're taking this place
come
back.
Here, come here, come here.
That's what's happening.
Oh, no one needs it.
Why are you all here in Speaker's Corner? Are you trying to convert everyone to Islam? Are you trying to convert everyone to Islam? Is that why you're here?
I don't even have it.
Is that why you're here every weekend? I'm asking you a question. Why are you here every weekend? Are you trying to convert everyone to Islam?
I want you to follow common law, which cause no loss, no harm or injury on anyone.
It's not built on the Bible.
You are?
It's not built on the Bible. It's a secular country. Is it bugging? It's a secular country.
No, it is a country that was based on Christian values. We were the Anglo-Saxons and we converted and we had Christianity. What I'm saying is, Islam, I'm not interested in scripture. What I'm saying is, Islam poses a threat to every one of us.
You're wrong. You need to go and do your research. Why do you think there were churches everywhere before there were Muslims?
We're trying.
Who are you doing? They've got nothing to do with stuff.
Christians murdering people, screaming God is great. No, they're not.
Who cares? They're killing people with a different charge.
Normal Muslims are killing non-believers.
So a Christian government, which is a government, tell me to follow.
We're against this government because they're
not. You're not because she told me to follow that law. The law that the government implements upon this country. You said that. She said follow the law of this government. A Christian law of this government.
What's wrong with him? His own friends have left him and become what?
What about
this? Become what? Become Allah! Allahu Akbar! There you go.
So, alright, if Islam's not a threat...
You asked the question, I answered. And
you've just said something about Tommy. Tommy's a legend. Tommy speaks to the majority of working class people.
Do you not understand? Do you not know how this works?
What about Didsbury Mosque? What about Didsbury Mosque? Answer me about that. Why shouldn't that be closed out? Every single mosque in this country is preaching hatred towards us. Why would I want to go into one? My safe
place.
I've had a debate with an imam. What's going on? Because Didsbury Mosque, because region's part.
And they still don't get it.
What's the matter? You're scared of him?
Ignorance.
No, man.
You're not scared of him?
No, man.
I can't say that.
I've never been to the church. I can't say. I went there year two. And now our children are being forced to go into mosque. What I'm saying to you is, can you not understand our concern?
No.
As English people, you don't.
Get rid of
it.
What
I'm saying to you is, Islam poses a threat to all of us, non-believers.
Let's look at Christians then.
Look at Lebanon. Look at what happened to Lebanon. Look at Palestine, what the Palestinians are doing to the Israelis.
Oh my God!
I don't know nothing.
I came from Palestine.
Mate, it's an illegitimate state funded on by terrorists. Hamas are terrorists. That's why you all like Jeremy Corbyn.
Hamas,
a prescribed Islamic terror organisation. It's not even a real country. It's not real. Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. Palestine didn't even exist. It was part of the Ottoman Empire. Palestinians have more rights.
Palestine's been there for over 100 years.
You wanted to be able to join. I know, I might have been taller than you or not.
Israel just became
real. No. We've had this discussion with people before. Palestine was part of the Ottoman Empire. Palestine was given its name by the Romans to discredit the Jews from the land.
It's because I know classical scholars that said in their works.
Well, they're wrong.
You're talking about 1,000 years ago.
Yeah.
He said, okay, I came from Palestine. He said this thousands of years ago. This guy saying the other day. This guy don't know nothing.
No, they're right. They're not violently attacking me.
He's a Tommy brainwashed kid. That's who he is.
Tommy's brainwashing
people. You don't know what you're saying.
He's
brainwashed you.
How is he brainwashed?
Do you think people want to take over your country?
There's not people in this country that want to be killing yourself. No, I'm speaking out about an evil. So why was there a Sharia ruling go through the British court? If the Islamisation of this country isn't happening, why have we got Sharia being put through our courts? There was a ruling about 2 or 3 weeks
ago. Stop lying,
this is Britain.
Jews got their own courts.
Huh? Yes. Jews have got their own hospitals. Marching about it. Jews ain't going around murdering people screaming God is great.
Okay, wait. Now they are.
Where?
Whenever you got power, then you see how people really are. Jews used to get persecuted. Now they got power. See what they're doing in Palestine.
You're going to say that Israel is a genocidal force.
I've seen it on my own eyes.
Yeah.
Have you been Palestine?
I wouldn't want to go. It's Muslim. I'd never go to an Islamic country. Never.
You don't have a clue.
Why would I? I don't want to give money to people that want to kill me.
You got one here. Why are you going to another one?
This is our land, mate. This is our land. And I'm telling you now, this Islamic caliphate that you've all got into your head, it ain't happening. It's not a phobia. It's not irrational to fear. No, it's not. There's millions of people in this country that just won't say anything because they're scared of losing their job.
The same way that I said about the Pope.
Who said I'm the brave one?
You say the Pope wants you to share.
I just don't back down from people I don't agree with. Simple.
You just jump around.
So what if I jump around? Look at your trousers. They're too short, mate.
Look at his trousers. Not lying,
Lomit. Oh, brilliant. I'm not ignoring anyone. All I'm saying to you is, you what? All I'm saying to you is, we fear Islam because we're seeing the effects of what's happening. Why? You're in this country, you get more rights than any of us.
My friend. Oi. My friend, you have nothing to fear about Islam. Take it from me. It's the fastest growing religion for a reason. You may want to look into it. Don't believe everything you read or see.
Because of birthrights.
Well, do you know what's so funny? If Muslims believe, there will be none of you left until you get rid of Muslims.
Who said they want to get rid of? I want to challenge this ideology because it's not compatible with the West. Marrying children is not compatible with the West. Halal food is barbaric, the same as kosher. It should be banned. See, it's not just Islam. The Jews do kosher food. I don't agree with that. I've got a problem with animals getting their throats slit. Yeah, it's right.
Animals getting their throats slit is a lot better than them being electrocuted and being put through a prison system.
Look, what was that recent Eid festival you had? I'm sorry for being ignorant. What was the last one called? Eid. Yeah. All these animals being slaughtered. It's wrong.
Yeah, Eid was a bloodbath. How can you lie? It's barbaric. Barbaric.
The lamb chops were nice.
Okay, so electrocution.
I don't eat halal.
You should see my Snapchat Eid days. What do you eat?
It's brutal. Why would you follow that? Don't you like animals? Don't you care for little animals?
Christmas. Not turkey. That's what barbaric. Gammon usually.
What's the gammon?
Animals, women and children should be cared for by men.
No, we'll take that into consideration.
My friend, how do you slaughter the gammon? Huh? How do you slaughter it?
Am I a farmer?
No, but no,
they kill it, I'd imagine. They
this is a trick question. This is a trick question. Women!
You don't kill it, you eat it.
People come
to places like this to have a chat, have a discussion about
it. That's right, that's right.
I genuinely fear for the future of this country if we continue the way we're going. Because of one reason, Jeremy Corbyn. Jeremy Corbyn.
According to him, he's got more chance than us.
Huh?
He's got more chance of becoming one more than us.
I doubt it.
That's what he said.
With that IQ, I doubt it, man.
I don't eat fish. So what I'm saying to you is, so we've got two threats, Islam and Jeremy Corbyn. Jeremy Corbyn, who you probably all support.
And Tommy Robinson, the threat.
How's Tommy Robinson a threat? How is he a threat? Tell me. How's he causing problems?
No, he's not.
He's
highlighting the problems that Islam brings to this country.
Are you a teacher?
Yeah.
Are you?
No. But I'm teaching you. As men, you should know that animals, women and children should be cared for. So why do you abuse animals? Do you abuse children and women?
You're talking about rape. Let's talk about slavery.
I agree.
Why is she not allowed to? Speaker's corner.
Watch out for what you lot do to kids.
Yeah, look at Mohammed. He abused the child.
Your father's putting a priest kid and you don't know about it.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, right.
When you say father, you mean
what? That's okay, is it?
Hey, brother! Come over here!
So that makes it okay to abuse children? Is that what you're saying?
Hold on, wait.